smaller country.
हेलो जीजो, वी कैन स्टार्ट इन 5 मिनट्स चले
वी कैन स्टार्ट इन 5 मिनट्स റെക്കോർഡിംഗ് ഞാനില് ചെയ്യുന്ന ലൈവ് യൂട്യൂബ് പോകുന്നുണ്ട് വി ബി സ്റ്റാർട്ടിംഗ് ലൈവ് യൂട്യൂബ് സർ ദെൻ ദാറ്റ് ഷുഡ് ബി എ പ്രോബ്ലം
ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ സോ ദെർ ഈസ് എ റെസ്യൂം ബാർ സ്റ്റോപ്പ് റെക്കോർഡിംഗ് സോ ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ റെക്കോർഡിംഗ് പോസ്റ്റ് ലൈവ് ഓൺ യൂട്യൂബ് സ്ക്രീൻ ഷെയറിംഗ് മാറ്റണ്ടേ ഇപ്പോ
സാറിന്റെ സ്ക്രീൻ ഷെയറിംഗ് അല്ലേ കിടക്കുന്നത്
ആ
അത് കിടന്നോട്ട് കുഴപ്പമില്ല
ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ
നമുക്ക് സംസാരിക്കാം സാറിന് പ്രയാസം വരും
യെസ് യെസ്
Shall we start, sir?
Yes.
Vinu, shall we start?
Yes, yes. Why not? Why not? It's already 7.
It's already 7.
Everyone will join.
Everyone should join.
We'll start. We will start.
Good evening, everyone. We today's session, we have been blessed with Himatray Bhavaskar, sir. Sir is coming to us from all the way from Maharashtra. Sir, as many of us, even though have not met, sir, we bet all of us who have seen a child with scorpion sting will definitely remember, sir. Some people will change few lives of people whom we meet. And sir is a person who has changed lives of many children who and adults who was ever in the, for not only in the current scenario and also for the future with his clinical acumen and research and giving his findings. His findings has been taken up world over as a primary treatment for scorpion bite. Sir has a lot of data, and above all, sir has been a clinician and a researcher for the last 25 years. It is our honor to listen to sir as to his crusade, as to how we went through all the phases. Even though scorpion bite is not common for us in Kerala, it is still an honor to have you with us. I've always listened to you as a resident, and it is always a pleasure to listen to you even after so many years, sir. Welcome to our talk, sir. I would invite our president, Dr. Binukutan, to give the presidential address.
Thank you, Dr. Jijo. Thanks to our dynamic secretary, Dr. Jijo, for bringing such a legend to this monsoon webinar series. And we are happy for the response we received for this monsoon extravaganza webinar series. It's the fourth talk. Actually, the last two talks were full. And we are having our state secretary Narayanan sir, respected Bala sir, secretary Bala sir, and so many senior pediatricians are there. And to moderate this session, then Jayakrishnan sir, who is the additional professor and in charge of PICU Calicut Medical College, Sir is the past president of IAP Critical Care Chapter and the past editor of IAP Pediatric Companion. So I'm handing over, before handing over to Jayakrishnan sir, I welcome Narayanan sir for his address. Over to you, sir.
Narayanan sir had advised not to go for an address so that we will save time and go ahead with the talk.
Okay, then over to you, sir, Jayakrishnan sir, to moderate this session. I mean, meeting you.
Good evening, friends. I feel really privileged and honored to be chairing this session where the speaker is none other than Dr. Himatrao Bhavaskar, who is actually a world-renowned authority on scorpion sting and snake bite. It was his observation that autonomic storm is the cause of life-threatening problems like pulmonary edema and circulatory failure in scorpion sting has changed the lives of thousands of scorpion sting victims. In fact, he observed that a drug, very cheap drug like prasosin, is effective in treating this child, and it has saved so many lives. Just in his state, Maharashtra, but I think the whole country. So it made a big difference in the lives of these people. And one more thing is that what is probably most inspiring is that he did all this research working in a very remote area in a village, Maharashtra. And he actually proved that research, medical research, actually quality research is possible in settings rather than in big corporate or big government tertiary hospitals. So with that introduction, I invite sir to start his talk.
Good evening to all. Though the scorpion sting is a rare problem in Kerala, but my lecture will give you the idea how to do a research. This is not, don't look at this lecture to be just scorpion, but look at how a research can be done in remote restricted area. When I joined the primary health center in Birwadi, in west coast area of the Maharashtra, which is 180 kilometer of Bombay, no sooner I joined, I noticed that maximum deaths were reported from primary health center. Every day we used to get one problem, another day we used to get dead bodies. So I was disturbed. I took a Hippocratic oath that day. I will come with some solution and I will solve the solution, because mortality was 30% when I joined the primary health center. With every day there was news in the newspaper that the death due to scorpion sting, death due to scorpion, young people, mothers, our fathers is dying of pulmonary edema. I gone mad to reading the news, to understanding the why this problem. I started admitting the patient at the primary health center. Nobody was there to advise me. Everybody was after the antivenom is not how will you treat the patient. So I studied myself and I came to know the problem that irrespective of given maximum amount of decongestive treatment, vanoxin, LASIK, amanapanin, oxygen, patient used to die of pulmonary edema, cardiac shock and cardiac arrest and ventricular arrhythmia. So ultimately I come to know something is wrong. Now, I was presenting these cases to the medical colleges, but they could not understand. So I was just, because patient of congestive cardiac failure not responding to decongestive treatment, by definition, it is refractory heart failure. And so refractory heart failure treatment of types of vasodilator. And vasodilator we use first, very first patient is sodium nitroprusside, gold standard treatment at primary health center, which patient will survive. And ultimately, by reading my various books and various journals, I came to do prazosin active orium sodium nitroprusside. And since the advance of prazosin, mortality is dropped to less than 1%. This is the advantage of simple prazosin drug of just a 20 rupees per 10 tablets. And my research was acknowledged by NHVARDI as a legend in neurology. My dear friends, see, the rural people taught you how to get restricted resources. Even today in COVID, the mask, natural mask they are wearing in the tribal community with the leaves. So this is a restricted resources. This research can be done. We are available. Whatever availability we got, we must add and take advantage of that available material and get it best utilized. So this is the lesson from tribal community. Now, when when a physician, surgeon, or a pediatrician working in the OPD or working in the ward or examining the patient, you should know the how important accuracy of sign. You change, you repeatedly visit to the patient. A visit to the patient is a visit to the pilgrimage, and you repeat and change the sign. You just confirm the sign. You will be damn sure this is the only sign. You can change the diagnosis according to sign. You can have a choice to change the diagnosis, because data, we must collect the data. Without data, we cannot make a complete recovery, William Osler says, and that is the nature. You must able to give the diagnosis by noting accuracy in the sign. Now you say, this is the primary health center. Here is the primary center where I was working for, working at Lue. This is my Makkah or campus of scorpion sting research. Now my hospital was laboratory, was patients and BP apparatus only, nothing else. Visit to the patient's bed is a visit to pilgrimage. And patient is a god and central of medical universe. Today in corona, the god door is closed, but the patient door is open. So ultimately, patient is a god. And because of this, I could able to add something in the medical research. Now, how the patient with common life-threatening emergency which are faced in the primary health center is a snake bite, Russell viper with the profuse bleeding, crate bite with the unknown bite, no bite at all, rat bite, ant bite, and no bite, come in the morning with the neuroparalysis, and patient may die of a neuroparalysis with the various diagnoses, acute appendicitis, stroke, Guillain-Barré syndrome, or tumor, encephalitis, or meningitis, ultimately it's nothing but a crate bite, and many patients come in, they say the massive pulmonary growth in the mouth is due to scorpion sting. Now, in the one day, we get many cases. This is the left side of the patient of scorpion sting recovered from pulmonary edema, and right side of the patient that crate bite recovering from neuroparalysis. So single day, we are getting many cases about scorpion and snake bite. Now, this is typically in the Konkan tract or in the Kerala. This is a paddy husk during the October month when they are harvesting the paddy. The dry husk underlies the scorpion. A maximum morbidity and mortality occur during the October and November month because these scorpions are more pregnant and more lethal and more inject the venom, which is more synthesis the venom, and maximum pulmonary edema reported October and November month. Now, how the patient come to me? Patient, because many times patient came to froth in the mouth, dead, pupils dilated, not reacting. We do the clinical autopsy. We ask the detailed history because nobody was guided. No textbook was mentioned, detailed clinical manifestation. Nobody was advised. Ultimately, I took to the clinical autopsy, and the history was like this. Patient gets a sting in the midnight or during afternoon. Patient has a mild pain to severe pain, profusely sweating. Then patient has a cold extremity. Patient has a vomiting. Patient become delirious, patient become hypertensive, then patient goes to the hospital, nobody ready to admit. Many patients are given atropine to for sweating, many dies of massive pulmonary. There is no place where the patient can be admitted. Each hospital refuses to admit the patient. Patient is approved the red color expectoration, oxygenated brick red color expectoration. This indicates it is a blood pulmonary vein. And pulmonary vein will indicate more pressure on the left end diastolic pressure and left atrial backflow to pulmonary vein. So oxygenated blood, this indicates left ventricle mass is more affected. Left ventricle impedance is increased. And impedance increased because of various factors, which certainly we'll see. And we x-ray with the bilateral batwing appearance of pulmonary edema. This is the cause, this is the mesobutus of red scorpion. Now, what do you see? This is a brick red color expectoration. This is a typical with the mild tachycardia. This kind of the pulmonary edema is because secondary to myocardial involvement. So myocardial is the secondary cause of pulmonary edema. Next, so you see different between two. This is a right is a snake bite, and this a left is a scorpion sting. Scorpion sting is active bleeding because of left ventricle and diastolic pressure. Pulmonary venous are ruptured, active red color oxygen blood. Right, the passive blood because of Russell viper, viper bite, where there is liberation of cells and loss by endothelial cells and loss of endothelial membrane, which cause the release of passive blood. So this is a deoxygenated venous blood, while the scorpion sting with the oxygenated blood. Simpler difference between two. See, look at this oxygenated blood. This is deoxygenated blood, is a snake bite. Now what we did is postmortem study. That time nobody was, nothing was available. So ultimately, solution is the postmortem. Similar like the corona COVID today, solution has gone by PM only. not by the clinical manifestation. Here we see the scorpion, there is a massive pulmonary lungs were flooded with eosinophilic fluid. Myocardium was damaged, there was minimum inflammation, minimum changes. The heart was enlarged and flabby. This indicates there's myocardial edema with pulmonary edema. Now various ECG changes. Beautiful ECG changes which the cardiologist has never seen in the life. Even the Brunwald have not seen such ECG changes. No ECG book has mentioned such changes. Mark UTC prolongation more than two minutes. The ventricular arrhythmia, where ventricular tachycardia is alternans. Brugada syndrome. This is Brugada syndrome, which typically is a transient. And we can get a cardiac arrest with a complete heart block. So various ECG changes, which is seen now, because of advance of progress in moderate treatment, these all ECG changes are gone in the museum. Now, next we thought, when I joined the primary health center in early stage 1976, out of 75 patients died, the mortality was 30%. Now, this is reported in 1978. In 1961, in my area, same where I was working, PM Mundley, the retired military captain, has reported same 29% mortality. So there was no change in the fatality from 1961 to 78. The medical science was proselytized, was not aware of this problem. WHO was not aware of this. No doctor take care. No pediatrician was reported dead due to scorpion sting to the higher authority. ICMR of India, which said is the topmost authority in the science, was not aware of this fatality because this is a problem of poor farmers and remote areas, always neglected even today. Now, what we say is that now when I gone to the post-graduation, my teacher says, please, after go to the co-contract, which is a gold mine for research, and I made it through. It is a gold mine. With that time, prepare a silage slides on the slide that early diagnosis, treatment, and management, early intervention will help the patient. Now, when the patient was in refractory heart failure, when the patient was not responding to the decongestive treatment, I was knowing that my professor has taught me, sometimes you can use a rotating tourniquet to alleviate the preload, just like LASIK also reduce the pharmacological phlebotomy, just like morphine, who is rotating preload, rotating tourniquet, only few patients survive. This skin death by reducing the preload, patient can be survived. This is a rotating tourniquet which I published in the Indian Heart Journal in 1977. In 1952, Brunwald has similarly said congestive cardiac failure can be prevented by venous section and rotating tourniquet. So this was a therapy. Why our science was neglected for many years? When Brunwald has published in 1952 that rotating tourniquet, nobody was advised me till I myself was able to do it. So ultimately, rotating tourniquet confirmed reduction of preload and afterload only will be the solution. Now, when whole life I am studying, see, from the complete black skull which has come to the gray, I become a bald one 40 years which are working. Initially, we are used to various atropine, avil, steroids. This is a digoxin, LASIK, and this used to patient used to die very high mortality. So ultimately, then I tried various other drugs. Chlorpromazine, when I used first sedate the chlorpromazine. Now chlorpromazine acts as alpha blocker. Many patients survived because of alpha blocking activity. Then ultimately, we come to know one by one, LASIK, digoxin, steroid will increase the mortality. So now the nepedipine come existent from Israel, that is, Jim Guram said you can use sublingual nepedipine for the children and mortality was reduced. But now the sublingual nepedipine have more adverse effect, we cannot use. And now digoxin direct still doesn't add. But when I had prazosin and nepedipine, mortality suddenly dropped to 1.6%. And when alone prazosin, mortality has almost gone to negligence. And all villages, all period approach, happy to admit the patient, treat the patient with the prazosin. And they say, no sooner we come the patient, we'll look at what the prazosin store and date of expiry of the drug. Even the Kerala doctor, some Pondicherry doctor says, we keep one strip of prazosin in our purse, which published in New England Journal of Medicine. So important, prazosin is very vital, most important, more vital, more expensive, and more expensive than the gold, though it is a cheaper drug. Now, what we get is severe local pain. So local pain is a big problem, I think, in the Kerala also. Now, this local pain, patient has no vomiting, no sedative, no autonomic storm. Patient with a severe local pain, he hold the limbs, he move the limbs, for more the pat arrest part, he will not get a resting place. So it's continuous severe pain. They apply some herbal medicine, they get herbal toxicity, and this is a scorpion with a generally black scorpion with a narrow tail. This is, remember, narrow tail and claws are very strong. This is a typically of the severe local pain which cause, and pain cannot be relieved by the single dose of xylocaine. Remember, repeated dose of xylocaine will cause more and more pain. So better to give a single dose than cold therapy and just make an assurance that patient will recover gradually. It will take 24 hours gradual waning of the patient. Next important, tourniquet they apply never necrosis which occurs, even the cyanosis which occurs tourniquet. Very important, his severe pain can cause bradycardia due to anxiety. Now various venomous, how to diagnose is venomous and non-venomous scorpion. Remember, these are upper side is a venomous. Look at the claws are slender and narrow. Look at the tail is stout and broader and wide. This is a very venomous. Non-venomous, the claws are strong and strong, bigger side, while tail is slender. This is a less venomous. So this is the character of the venomous and non-venomous thing. Now, Nigmata, what clinical manifest? We get profuse sweating. Sweat literally flows like a flood. And this is called skin diarrhea. And all electrolyte balance is lost. That's why we must take care of electrolyte balance. You get a frothy, expectoration. That is very patient comes severe cup, unable to expectorate. And this frothy, which is a thick sputum, which is because of glandular secretion of the saliva, which cause the frothy sputum and difficult to expectorate. Patient get expected with a red blood stain. Cold extremities, that's like ice cold extremities, just like washerman's hand, because of severe vasoconstriction. These are most clinical manifestations we get in the scorpion stain because of this salivation, thick salivation, sweating. Next, important, many times in children, because of hypertension crisis, or some parasympathetic tone is increased, we get oculogyric crisis. And that's it, we should not forget, it's just like encephalopathy, oculogyric acid, down here, ophthalmoplegia. Many times these patients are dying of ptosis and given antiscorbutic venom. So this is one has to differentiate. How to differentiate? Patient gives HDF, vomiting, sweating, cold extremity, and severe paroxysm in main child. This is differential diagnosis. Many times such children are diagnosed as a snake bite by diagnosing ptosis. This is a ophthalmoplegic crisis. A severe priapism is one of the diagnostic signs, but not a prognostic sign. Now, this priapism is very common, may persist for 16 to 24 hours. This is involuntary painful erection of the penis, which persists for a long time. The patient can urinate. That's a very important. Priapism is a very diagnostic sign. Recently, this year, we have seen a patient of 16-year child who has a persistent priapism for 21 days. It takes 21 days. We did a Doppler study in Doppler shows poor penile dorsal vein flow. And now ultimately this patient has been recovered with a low molecular heparin and aspirin for 10 to 15 days. So this indicates persistent priapism should be taken care of with the anticoagulant. And that's why in this report, we are noting that many times when the patient comes with the tachycardia, this tachycardia at the same time, you must administer antiplatelet, or many of these tachycardia may develop paralysis, strokes. And this should be taken care of when the patients, particularly in children, got a tachycardia. This is a very, very important priapism also. Next important, look at the cold extremities. When there is no vein domain prominence at all, why is cold extremity? And this is a good monitor, thickened skin. We can get a thickened skin over the knuckles. And this is a very good sign. Still the patient warm and cold extremity, cold and cold extremity or vasoconstriction, patient is bad. Because of vasoconstriction, patient gets a sting at the peripheral part. So because of vasoconstriction, there is no conduction of the pain at all. Because of anoxious of pain conducting fiber, patient has no pain due to scorpion sting. One will forget the idea, one will neglect that this is not scorpion. But when the patient started processing, when vasodilatation occurs, anoxic of the conducting nerve is lost, improved, and patient pain perception is increased. So reappearance pain is a good sign in scorpion sting. It's a sign of recovery in severe autonomic storm. So all over India, reporting of the scorpion cases are coming now all over India. And that's why you all are interested in how the treatment, because reports are coming. And why I want to deliver, interest of my interest is that many of doctors still, many pediatricians, you ask me what is the treatment. So this is important. Every pediatrician, every doctor should know, aware of the treatment of scorpion. In the life, they may get you 2 cases of pulmonary edema. If they two die, is 100-200% mortality in your lifetime. That should be reduced by aggressive processing. Now this is, look at that. This is a red scorpion which is in my area, and the black scorpion which is the rest of the area, other part. But the which I say the toxicity, which is venomous. Look at both scorpion structure anatomically is the same. Flanks are, the claws are slender, while this tail is wide and stout. This is a venomous. So this is black scorpion, tail is venomous. ECG changes are the same tentative. This is from another district and this is from my district. So comparatively, though the anatomical look and color is different, but anatomy is similar, the venom is the same pattern which can be presented. Now, where you look at it, many times we get a T tentative. Tentative may be more than the RVOs, but with the treatment of prazosin, electrolyte imbalance, within 8 hours, tentative disappears or reduced. This is called dynamic cardiovascular. This is a dynamic AC changes you occur. That's why the doctor treating a patient of scorpion should be highly dynamic. He should not sit in the chair only. He should by the side of the patient and follow the patient, because the momentum on, hour to hour, minute to minute changes occurring. That's why the editor of the BMJ has told why they accept my paper, because the author says he sit with the by side of the patient till he recover. So this is important. We must say, because it is a dynamic. At time, BP may be higher time. Sometimes BP suddenly goes down. Patient goes in delirium. So this is a very, very important thing. One should sit by the side of patient. And remember, one doctor should be in charge if the patient is recovered. Otherwise, patient comes, doctor changes, doses alter, clinical manipulation cannot be followed, cannot remember. So patient may die of our great grave mistakes. Next important thing, mark the tachycardia. Patient can develop a tachycardia and improve prazosin, reperfusion of idioventricular rhythm. This is a prazosin which has caused coronary vasodilator, has improved myocardial function, and this is called a reperfusion idioventricular rhythm. This is a very diagnostic that prazosin is acting now, idioventricular tachycardia, ventricular antiarrhythmia, which has caused sign of reperfusion. Now, this is marked tachycardia children, particularly more. Your heart rate may go to 160 to 180 on 210. I have seen a children heart rate of 300. And this heart rate can be improved with the, remember, I was talking this time only. When the child comes with the marked tachycardia, child has treated with the process. Child has well balanced with hydrated. Child, now many times this child, because of prazosin child, 10% child will go in tachycardia. Warm extremity, tachycardia, ear hunger, pulmonary edema, cardiogenic shock, mitral shock. And this patient to be treated with dopamine, not with noradrenaline or dopamine at all. Dobutamine, BiPAP for respiratory system, and dobutamine, patient will survive with the dobutamine. Dose is 5 to 15 microgram per kg body. Additional to improve the myocardial function, you can add carnitine. Or next important is, if the tachycardia persists, you cannot ivermectin. This now available in the India for the treatment of tachycardia, which has no action on the myocardium at all. So we can use, rather than beta blocker, ivermectin is a drug can be used to reduce the tachycardia in addition to dobutamine. Please, at this stage, never use a beta blocker. Never use carvedilol. Many cardiologists say carvedilol. Carvedilol will kill the patient, because here ejection fraction may be 15 or 10. Unless you got a monitor of echocardiography and our cardiologist, let him use and let him use the grave consequences and let him become with the patient. That's very important. So we should know very restricted resources, and we should prevent the marching a patient to the graveyard. We unstick the patient as early as possible, please. Now, in if you study, you see why I can publish many articles, because I close. You see, one patient has this single patient disease, ventricular tachycardia, ventricular fibrillation, atrial fibrillation, fascicular tachycardia, complete heart block, and all not changes are seen in one patient followed up. So this is the perfect, which we are seeing autonomic storm, which are giving various clinical manifestations. That's how we are jumbled. The cardiology get confused. Treating physician get confused. Whether to treat ventricle trigger, by this time he raised the defibrillator pad, tachycardia disappears. When you got a bradycardia, when it's RC frenally, bradycardia disappears. So this is a dynamic cardiology vision. You must follow. My dear friend, in my throat life, not a single patient died suddenly. Unless it is a malfunction of malmanagement. If you give high dose of steroid, if you give high dose antihistamine, which cause more QT prolongation, torsadipine sudden death. So drug which cause QT prolongation should not be given in this vaccine. For example, ofloxacin, ciprofloxacin, this is azithromycin, and other drugs should be avoided in this victim, other will face a sudden death. And that is the reason why we should give a restricted drug. And this arrhythmia is because of liberated free fatty acid, liberated free radicals, and liberated decreased insulin secretion. Now the prazosin will improve the insulin secretion, improve the free fatty acid, decrease the free radicals, and will correct the arrhythmia. So azoprazosin is a complete anatomical and physiological antidote to scorbutic venom action. Now what we say, various changes. Look at, this is a various change. Left bundle bond like pattern. This is a tocosomal cardiomyopathy like pattern. Mar tachycardia, mar gaze, left AST elevation. Now we can get delayed. It is our published annals of drug repertory. Mar myocardial infarction pattern with QT prolongation. This patient was given antihistamine by the referring doctor, Vandijo Mendoza, and patient got a QT prolongation. Next important, this patient, old man, which come with a scorpion sting, patient had active myocardial infarction. Because of the atherosclerosis, this catecholamine, acetylcholine rather than dilatation cause vasoconstriction because of exposed to underlying smooth muscle. There is loss of atherosclerosis, endothelium line, and we get myocardial infarction and thrombosis because of free radical, and this causes a coagulation factor, and that's why we can get hemiplegia, infarction in this victim, and stroke. So in this patient, we have to thrombolyze, and after thrombolyze, give antivenom, and patient has a reprimand, ventricular tachycardia, ventricular, we have to give a DC shock, and patient recovered. So simultaneously, a physician, pediatrician must have all knowledge of cardiology to treat a scorpion sting issue, not only the arrhythmia, but if the child can develop infarction. Next important, atrial fibrillation. Yes, you can get atrial fibrillation. And just treating, we get a bioequivalent and recovery of the patient occur by treatment. But that's why we must use aspirin in this case. Next important, mar bradycardia. Patient has a left bundle bradycardia, heart rate 32. We just improve the hydration, just started the prazosin, improve the patient. Only importance of the BP. BP, if the BP is above 90, no need to intervene. Never, never give atropine. Atropine will deteriorate this patient very fast, which I published long time in the toxicology. Next important, this is a new sign which I detected recently. We get a left bundle bond plot type, but monophasic complex. Look at the ECB, just like a monophasic complex. This is called as a, this is a helmet sign, which is a new sign we detected this year. This is a helmet sign which can recovery with dobutamine and prazosin recovery which occur with pulmonary edema. This is a helmet sign which is a recently newly noted in scorpion sting, which is because of mar monophasic complex. And this monophasic complex suggests there is mar edema of the myocardium. Pulse, where the pulse is pulsing very slow. The electric conduction pulsing very slow, edematous method giving the monophasic complex. Even we can get T-wave alternance. This is indicate severe myocardial injury. We get T-wave. So ECG, you should be a masterpiece in ECG. Next important, massive pulmonary. Look at the pulmonary with the cardiomegaly, which occurs transient cardiomegaly with mild tachycardia. This patient requires dobutamine and bipap. Please avoid the intubation. Intubation will take. Never, even we have seen the patient was put on Schwann gas catheter for taking the pressure. Or a patient is expert in red blood. What for Schwann gas catheter? It indicates the endiathric pressure is more than 20. Next important, similar changes, a monophasic complex coming from one medical college. I receive a phone call. This is the ECG. Patient is pulmonary edema, and they are giving noradrenaline dopamine. I say, stop the dopamine and dobutamine, start dobutamine. Within 3 hours, patient improves pulmonary edema. So this is a pathophysiology. It's a very important to understand the why this occurring, why the pulmonary edema is occurring. Next, various type of pulmonary edema are getting. Bilateral pulmonary edema, unilateral pulmonary edema, just like ERDS. This is nothing but ERDS. Why this ERDS? It is autonomic storm. And we are getting ERDS COVID due to cytokine storm. So this is the typical pathology. We got a many problems, scorpion sting management. You know the slide from black hair to gray hair, complete to baldness. Same is to the COVID is happening today now. See, the many confusion. Now regarding, look at this is autonomic storm. We get a ERDS and this cytokine storm, just similar changes which are occurring. So what we are thinking about this? Now could cytokine storm be elevated by 2 days drug as elevated by this autonomic storm? Next important, you see, maximum pulmonary edema with mild tachycardia and recovery occurs. When with the recovery, when looking at the X-ray and child is recovered, we feel happy. Now the echocardiogram is very important. My time echocardiogram not available. Now is out. We have seen ejection fraction 15%, 30%. A patient in pulmonary took 1 to 2 weeks to recover. And this the myocardium is stunned. There is no contraction of the myocardium at all for a few seconds. The septum is not contracting at all. So stunned myocardium because of a sudden pouring of catecholamines, increased afterload and preload, myocardium has become sudden stun. And this stunning of myocardium will pull up input of calcium. Calcium load in the myocardium increase. This causes stunned myocardium. And that is the reason we should, as early as possible, reduce the preload and afterload, which will give the rest to the heart and improve the myocardial function. Yeah. Now we have seen this. Now we say the red scorpion. Now here's the black scorpion in some area, but the anatomically the same. Patient come with pulmonary edema, maximum. See, peripheral. You do the CT scan of this patient, will give that today. If you send this patient CT scan, they will diagnose COVID ground glass appearance. Now this primary edema, now noradrenaline dopamine was started in medical college. This is the last 6 months slide. And patient was, when I received the X-ray, I say start dopamine and patient improved. So simple understanding of the pathophysiology has been on previous of the inotrope should be avoided except dopamine in this patient. Now, what is scorpion? Why this occurred? Now scorpion delays the closing of neuronal sodium channel. So just maintain the opening of neuronal sodium channel. So neuronal sodium channel causes liberation of excessive catecholamine, neuronal stimulation, and this sudden pouring of excessive catecholamine, it inhibits the calcium activated potassium channel. Now this results in, because of autonomic stimulation, the sympathetic and parasympathetic. There is vomiting, sweating, salivation, privation, and parasympathetic. This is a transient phenomenon. While the tachycardia, hypertension, pulmonary is prolonged. So sympathetic stimulation is prolonged. Parasympathetic stimulation is a transient. When the victim come in the parasympathetic stimulation, this indicates the venom is circulating in the blood. And that is the stage anti-venom will war. If the patient come in the warm asthmatic tachycardia and pulmonary edema, and this patient has mild tachycardia, no sweating, salivation, here anti-venom is not war. Because the target organ has been already disturbed by this venom and adrenaline and noradrenaline secretion, where antivenom is not in the circulation at all. So antivenom will not act. So when to give antivenom is at this stage, you should know. If the patient comes vomiting, sweating, priapism, cold, give antivenom. If the patient comes with hypertension, tachycardia, warm expectation, pulmonary edema, antivenom is out. Now, second patient got it because of alpha stimulation, you know, expression of the glucose from the liver, and we get hyperglycemia. So this victim has a raised blood sugar level. Decreased insulin secretion because of alpha stimulation causes a decreased insulin secretion. Now, prazosin, phosphodiesterase stimulation is increased cyclic GMP. It increases nitric oxide synthesis, natural oxide synthesis in endothelium, inhibits the endothelium. And now because of increased cyclic GMP, the potassium channel is open and insulin secretion is increased. Now, my dear friends, here because of increased insulin secretion, pre-fatty acid has closed down, people are burned away. Now where there is hyperglycemia there, potassium is already raised in the, because we have seen a tentative even raise potassium. So glucose, potassium, and this insulin. So GIK drip is formed naturally in the body, which protect, which use myocardium stabilization. So GIK, what OP has advised long time before late of 20th century, GIK drip will help for the myocardial failure and refractory edema. Now, this is a very what we publish in New England Journal of Medicine. A similar thing, adrenergic, cholinergic cluster, neuromuscular blocker, which common in Kerala because of scorpion, which causes neurogenic, we may get a neuromuscular blocker, facial nerve, cranial nerve involvement, weakness, fatigability, which is seen in Kerala. Ultimately, this all clinical line phase, if you not treated in time, patient get arrhythmia, atrial ventricular tachycardia, T wave changes, myocardial dysplasia, hypotension, shock, and pulmonary dementia. So this is a pathophysiology which I published long back, is a review in the New England Journal of Medicine. Now this is again 97. ASV has come now. ASV has come and we have given a trial of ASV. Now this we published in long back in the Lancet, a diagnostic sign, vomiting, sweating, and tripism is a diagnostic sign of cardiac, precardiac manifestation, which accepted as a direct my paper without sending a peer review. This is the editor, Ian Monroe, has abstracted this paper in 1 week. And he received a letter from the London, UK, that said this paper is accepted directly. And he advised me, he take my permission to correct my English. Now Indian General has rejected this paper. And then they requested my reprint. This is a fortune. You say, my dear friend, if you read today's Lancet editorial, today's Lancet editorial, why China has decreased the cases of COVID? The minister, their officer, they say, front people are scientists. They are given all facilities. They are listening, all minister, all government listening to the scientists and obeying them. Reverse is occurring in India. That is the reason why we are not completely able to close the pandemic. You, everybody should read today's Lancet editorial, my dear friend, because they have very nicely mentioned why the China has improved the COVID pandemic. Now, legendary, my dear, what happened when the pulmonary edema? One day, when I complete my MD, I decided to use nitroprusside, sodium nitroprusside. Patient has come with child with the pulmonary edema. I started sodium nitroprusside, and patient recovered. This is the first patient recovered of sodium nitroprusside. I started dancing because this is the first patient recovered from sodium nitroprusside, and this is sort of nitroprusside cannot be applied anywhere in the primary center. So ultimately, I read the paper and then prazosin is oral sodium nitroprusside. On same day when this patient recovered, my father died. I could not attend his funeral because this child, no doctor will treat the child. The father has donated this child to my research, so it is immaterial to attend the funeral because we take the oath of Hippocrates. It is our duty to unstake the stake patient rather than giving a shoulder to the dead body. Now this again we prazosin published 1986, which has become homework. Now pre-prazosin mortality was very high, post-prazosin almost reduced. Now this many times when prazosin patient BP may raise, if you forget the second, third hour dose, and that time, if you give sorbitrate, patient will deteriorate very fast because prazosin, pyridoxine, and with the sorbitrate should not be given simultaneously. So avoid sorbitrate sublingually in this victim. Now, this antivenom has come in existence now 2004 only, and we plan a trial at the rule of the primary, at a private hospital. We got 70 patients, 35 patients with the prazosin plus antivenom. And another patient is prazosin alone. So we did a trial, the randomized trial. We come to know that sweating, saliva, pyrosis, and cardiac recovery time is shortened with the prazosin and antivenom. You see, when the vomiting, sweating come, antivenom will neutralize the circulating venom. But already venom liberated before reaching to the hospital, before venom reaching to the circulation, the autonomic storm which has occurred caused tachycardia, hypertension, alpha receptor stimulation, that taken care of. So both drugs are simultaneously acting and mortality is almost, and recovery is within 8 hours. No need to admit the patient more than 8 hours. Now this article published in British Medical Journal. randomized start with a cover illustration of Scorpio. Nobody has read in India. Nobody has sent me the compliment of that it is a proud of my India that we got a cover illustration of Scorpion in British 200 years old general, British medical journal. And now, my dear, many papers, many letters published in the Lancet, more than 31 publications. Now, BMJ, we got a randomized, this is a diagnostic treatment. We got a RCT and review. So are these three leaders in the medicine? These are called the leaders in the medicine. Is my publication occur on 3 liters. This is called academic value. You should be received by academic wealth, not by Mercedes cars or money wealth. So our doctor, our academician should be rich and they should have academic wealth. Now, my dear friends, indication of scorpion antiprosthesis in autonomic staff, vomiting, priapism, hypertension, hypotension, hypertension, pulmonary and scorpion thing, history may not be history, but priapism is there. Now, this is all stages we have discussed. Stage 1, swelling, early stage come. Stage 2, stage 3, if the patient comes. Stage 4, less stage, we can use dopamine. Now this is scorpion is over. Now, you see, this is synapse. Now, we'll start with a snake bite. Crusade against that. Now, another problem, we have faced snake bite. So, common big 4 snake all over India is a crate, cobra, Russell viper, and Ichthys carinatus. And you got this is some separate snake in our area, that Cochin area. This is antivenom is not available. Now this we say, Russell viper will get bleeding. Great, we get a neuroparalysis. Typical young earning members of family, life-threatening and time-limiting. Patient come with a mid in the night with a pain in abdomen, floor away, vomiting, mild sweating, unable to lift the neck, then we get suffocation. Early in the morning, come with the OPD with the ptosis. Medical officer give the history that bitten, no history of bite, rat bite, ant bite, or no bite at all. Pain in abdomen. Surgeon put light leg pressure rather than seeing the eyes. Diagnose appendicitis. Now another come in neurologist diagnose encephalitis. Neurologist diagnose GB syndrome. Another come with encephalitis, meningitis, and somebody diagnose hysteria. And patient dies. Very important thing, my dear friend, remember, in the neuroparalysis is a descending. By Gualibari, it is ascending neuroparalysis. Simple thing. If we get a ptosis, we get unable to bring the tongue out, then unable salivation, then progress should happen. This is a descending neuroparalysis, is a great bite. So this is very important. Diagnosis, early members, earning members of family, history of floor pain, woke up in the pain in abdomen, weakness and morning ptosis, diagnose crate bite unless and until proved otherwise. You will diagnose, treatment will give the best solution, and you look and you will see when the patient recovers, you will look, you met the God on this earth. Now, what it says, the little knowledge is dangerous to society. You must have knowledge of the snake bite detail. You got a chapter, you got a many textbook on the snake bite. And if you're not aware of this, the danger society and medical negligence crime, patient of snake bite, crate bite midnight, pain in abdomen, suffocation, peripheral doctor diagnosed as the bronchopneumonia, give her a diclofen and antibiotic intramuscular, sent home, barley in the morning, patient was brought dead, nothing but a crate bite. Failure of taking a proper history. If you say by the examination taken during taking history and examining, if the patient died of disease, is welcome rather than wrong diagnosing, killing him with the wrong treatment. So next is the cobra bite, which is very important. Woman was just collecting the paddy husk, and she was bitten by the cobra, and she died within 1 hour. Though the ASV was available, the PhD doctor did not administer the ASV. So this is the biggest crime. Why I did a research? I felt when my son, my wife, my mother, my brother, or my father gave a snake bite, I will be disturbed. If I disturb like this while treating the patient, I will get success. Now, next, high mortality. India has a very high mortality because of negligence, medical negligence. 2 HIV, 1 patient, so many grand of HIV, but mean now because of the repeated hammering of the Lancet, repeating hammering the WHO, now it is neglected in the tropical neglected disease, snake bite, and we are getting many grant, many research. Reason of high mortality is poor transport. Now this is over. We got a good transfer. There is no question about it. Delayed report in tantric, going to the mantric and create bile, because patients do not give the history of bile, go on sleeping. They are relatives not aware of that bile. A patient may be delayed by reporting hospital. Who are training up a doctor? Doctors is not aware. That's it. Snake bite is not our job. They should be given proper, perfect training. Supportive treatment must be available. Very important. ESV, ventilator. Many times ESV is not available. It is a duty of medical officer to procure. It is not a duty of a government. Ventilator, if not AmbuVac, simple AmbuVac, BiPAP, this can be available. Supportive treatment. Poor training of a doctor. Illiteracy of a doctor. They say we are virulent, we are MD, DM, and they don't know how to treat scorpion bite and myocarditis. So it is called illiteracy of a doctor. Lack of confidence of giving ESV. Many a medical officer said, we don't have confidence to give the ESV because of anaphylaxis. Forget anaphylaxis. You see, if the cobra bite patient comes, if you don't give ESV, patient died, it's a crime. If a patient gets cobra bite, can give ESV. If patient develop anaphylaxis, you give adrenaline, your attempts are made and patient died, nobody will hang to you. You are sad. So this is very important. Giving ESV is a very, very important venomous bite. Lack of confidence, fear of anaphylaxis reaction. You see, we got a very good antidote adrenaline. No need to fear to give ASV at all. Next, part anyone. This is tribal school. Here, jungle, very many schools are built up in the jungle, and many cases, many children died of crate by the unknown days, morning brought, what happened, nobody knows. While going to hospital, these are all crate bite because maximum tribal students sleep on the floorway. Now, this is negligence. What is negligence? If the Gadi was here, poor man, waiting in the hospital OPD for a doctor is one of the risk factors. He should be given a first preference because venom is not stopped. Venom is not delayed because doctor is not available. Venom has started, no sin bite has occurred. So you should give first preference, not make him to wait. If you make him wait, you are adding to his death. That is important. So snake bite patients should not be allowed to wait in OPD at all. Next important, suppose snake bite patient, you don't know the snake. You can prepare a chart and copy photographs of the various snakes. At least many victims have saw the snake, and many bring the photograph now in the mobile, that's the advantage of the mobile. And look at, you show the photograph. So you say that this is local sign, this is snake, so Russell Viper. So you can make the photograph and show to the victim that he has might have seen the snake and they can identify. Next important, what are the risks for loose stone around the house? Firewood, harvesting the grass, so spraying of the barefoot spraying, walking barefoot, barefooting in the soybean plantation. These are all, now all the patients which can be more risk. These are the farmers, labor, brick workers, which are the poor man's disease. Now this is a woman who has come with a crate bite, early mid bite, and brought a snake crate like this. This is the space where below the door, there are slit between the base and the doorkeeper, which entered the crate. You see, crate is a nocturnal inhabitant. Crate fangs are very small. We'll discuss later on why the crate are coming during night hours. Now, very important, what we see the mortality, almost all the mortality is reduced from 1998 to the 2018 almost, but only mortality remains high in the crate bite because of this delayed appearance, delayed diagnosis, and not available ventilator, AmbuVac in peripheral hospitals. Now, Linkartus, what is now this very important? Most common see the June to September, October month, more highest rate of snake bite which occur in monsoon period. In the August now, today we are treating the snake crate bite in the government hospital. This is the month where the maximum case of crate bite, because these are the breeding seasons of a crate. Now this is maximum per month we get. Next important, let us see the venomous. If the snake is a dark color, dark skin is a poor conductor of the heat. So because of body temp, because these are cold-blooded animal, because of increased poor conduction, the heat in the body is increased. Temperature of the body snake is increased. Because of increased temperature, venom in the liquid form. Now, because of liquid form, in the one bite, in the small time, a fraction of second, maximum venom is injected. When it is a non-dark or bright color, it is a good conductor of the heat. The body temperature is low. The venom is risky, less venom is injected. That's why dark skin, black cobra is more poisonous than the other cobra. So that's why the dark skin snakes are more venomous. Now, what are the snakes? Various pathophysiology. We can get cytotoxicity, cobra bite called local necrosis, cytotoxicity, neurotoxicity, neuromuscular blocker, which can hematoxicity, bleeding disorder, viper bite, cardiotoxicity, which can see viper bite and cobra bite, myotoxicity in the sea snake bite, rhabdomyolysis, and nephrotoxicity, which is again in the viper bite, which kill the by renal failure. These are the various toxicity. Now, let us see the crate bite. Crate bites are nocturnal habit. His fangs is short and sharp like a insulin needle. So when his bite, the patient is not aware at all. It's during the nocturnal data enter in the house to hunt the rats. And when it enter in the house because of cold season during monsoon period, in the warm cloth in the building, it enter in the floor bed. And when during the second sleep, that is sleep, when the patient goes in the deep sleep, he is not aware of the bite at all. He moves the limb involuntarily, and the REM sleep involuntary movement, the crate feel it is a movement, is a rat, it bites, and the fangs are this venom is tainted poison than cobra. During the sleep, the reflexes are blunted. That's why it injects the maximum venom. Next important thing, during sleep, circulation to the skin is poor. As a result of it, venom is deposited and slowly absorbed. That is the reason why the clinical magic crate bite is late. And sleeping on the fire is sleeping on the floor bed. Caught patient never. You see, okay, I want to share the story here. You know, in my area, in one year, 30 patients of crate bite has come only from Hindu village, not in Muslim. So I've gone and seen the Muslim community. Muslim community always sleep on the cot. Maximum use the mosquito net and less so. Floor bed is the main cause. If you use cotton proper mosquito net, there will no crate bite at all. May diagnose after we have discussed Loughran syndrome, GP syndrome, and stroke. Now important is a crate. So local sign, crate fangs are very. There is minimum local sign, just like a pinhead marking. Look, you when you crate bite, you survey the whole body of the victim. You may get a fine marking period. An important thing, at around the pinhead marking, you must have urticaria. Local increase inflammation indicates patient is venom. If there is no urticaria, it may be dry bite. So many times, patient come with neuroparalysis and they will bite on the backside. And this is a crate. Patient improve. So we bite on the back. Now, many times, patient multiple bite on the hand, patient is not aware. We get a reflex, person multiple bite with a profound paralysis. In the profound, only reflexes are present. Patient is profound paralysis, a deep paralysis, just like comato. Then we get an absence of reflex, second stage, an absence of reflexes is a very bad sign. And if you follow this patient, if the reflexes come, patient will recover within the next 12 hours. So ankle reflex monitoring is very important. Next important, you see, this patient has come with an unknown bite. Now, what happened, nobody knows. Patient was brought unconscious, and prepared doctor gave him some IV saline, some injection. When come to the waist, I call in to see the patient. I was just standing from the head of the patient. I just put my hand on the scalp, the frontal scalp of the patient. I said, look up. So there was slight movement of the scalp, which because scalp is the bilaterally innervated. And we get patient is conscious. The patient look like be unconscious, but is a conscious because of profound paralysis. He is unable to move, unable to explain, unable to speak, but he is conscious because venom never plus the blood-brain barrier at all. Next important, child come with a look at the pain in a broken neck sign. If you lift the shoulder, the neck falls suddenly. It's called broken neck sign. Confirm this is a neuroparalysis and patient recover. So patient only come with a pain in abdomen. Now this pain, important of this, patient has just yes, like myasthenic face, look like a myasthenic, ptosis, mice, no expression at all. Because of this, you see expression indicate more receptors, more acetylcholine receptors are in the body, active muscle, multiple thousands of facial active muscles are there, and this called more receptor, more venom is blocked, that's a myasthenic look, and excessive salivation, this salivation which the patient cannot swallow, so spitting and excessive salivation. Remember tourniquet and this is site and neuroparalysis. Here is a caveat. Never, never relieve a tourniquet unless full dose of antivenom is administered. You may have a gangrene here, but never lose the tourniquet unless until full dose, that is 100 ml of ESV in crate bite, 20 ml of ESV in Russell Viper bite, unless and until you never relieve the tourniquet, either a patient will suddenly lapse in pulmonary edema or respiratory failure. Now, this many times patient bring the crate, but there is no sign at all, no neuroparalysis. Just observe, this is a dry bite. Patient, snake has straightened. There are two types, professional bites and threatened bites. So this professional bite, patient bite and inject the venom. Defense bite is less threatened, never inject the venom. Next important is that this very important, two snakes look like similar. This is a wall snake and this is a crane. Many times patient come with this snake, he come with walking, doctor untrained, see the snake, look at the symptom crate, give antivenom, and patient may die of anaphylaxis, where antivenom not necessary. How to differentiate? Look at the tail. Look at the tail of the crate. Tail of the crate, wide brand, extend up to the complete end of the tail, while wide brand is absent on the tail of the wall snake. This is the most diagnostic. So look at the tail. This is very important. Next important, crate bite, maximum in midnight to early morning. Floor bait, 99% history of floor bait. When you bring the kill snake, anywhere in the body, but sting bite can occur any part of the body, not essentially to the limbs. Next important, various all symptoms we get, pain in the abdomen, chest pain, ECG, T-inversion, diagnosed, angina, inversion, admitted in coronary care, knee, muscle, tenderness over muscle can be seen many times abdominal pain, vomiting, difficulty in deglutition, sweating, bilateral torsion, blurred vision, suffocation, ophthalmoplegia, pooling of saliva, hypertension because of presynaptic block. This is a presynaptic blocker. Release of postsynaptic. You see, postsynaptic alpha blocker is adrenaline secretion. Presynaptic inhibit the postsynaptic. Ultimately, the adrenaline secretion is inhibited. When the presynaptics are blocked, the release of postsynaptic, we secrete more and more adrenaline, patient develop hypertension. Many times, patient develop pulmonary edema with a crate bite, severe hypertension, need nitroglycerin. Bradycardia, attack pulmonary edema, quadriplegia, neck drops, and respiratory depression. Now the cobra bite. Cobra bite, many patients dies of anxiety, hyperventilation, feeling of threat, sudden death because catecholamine, myocardial infarct, severe pain at the bedside, bitten part. Never pain in the crate bite, no pain at all. Like a rapid swelling which occurs, ecchymosis, blebs, fangs marked with the blood clot. Remember it, the fangs marked with blood clot, blebs, necrosis, ulceration, contraction, cardiac arrest sudden, and respiratory depression can develop sudden, and then ptosis. So important, my dear, let me pass a remark here. No sooner the cobra patient come with a respiratory depression or respiratory, drug of choice is neostigmine and atropine, not the ESV. You give a neostigmine and atropine, salvage the respiration, then you can start the ESV. So first drug of choice in cobra bite and respiratory failure with neostigmine, atropine, then ventilator, then BiPAP, and then ESV. Next important, we can get a ventricular ectopic and shock because of hypercatecholamine, just the witness the snake. Then we get ptosis, bilateral ptosis. Then oxygen, gradually ESV, neostigmine, atropine, ESV patient improving 6 hours. Now very important now, whether this patient respond to neostigmine or simple ice bag test can be done. You can have a gloves or put with the one finger with ice, and put over the ptosis eye cold because of this hypothermia sensitize the acetylcholine receptor to existing acetylcholine. If you hypothermia produce, if the improve the ptosis, this patient go to respond to the neostigmine rather than having a trial of short acting neostigmine is not available. Next important, see, many times this is recently reported from the Dhule district. This child was admitted within 1 hour cobra bite. Ptosis improved with the neostigmine atropine. He was kept in admission. After 24 hours, he was given 25 of ESV and neostigmine atropine. After 24 hours, he relapsed again in ptosis. So relaxation is very important observation of snake bite, cobra bite particularly, because the bite site acts as its depot. When there is necrosis, the venom is necrosis tissue slowly absorbed because loss of vascularity. And that's why there is a slow absorption venous occur in next 24 hours and patient relapse. So relapsation of cobra bite can occur, which will require ESV, neostigmatropine. That's a close monitoring of this victim is very important. Next important, neostigmine, everybody knows 5 milligrams, 30 minutes, 3 doses, prescribe atropine, improve the continuous. And this is a pediatric dose you can decide of the pediatrician. You can add a calcium gluconate, improve the neuromuscular conduction. Now this pre-synap, now the cobra bite is a post-synaptic blocker, which is reversible. While the crate bite is a pre and post-synaptic, which is irreversible. So in a crate bite, because this venom damages the receptor, destroys the receptor, and that's why regeneration took more than 1 to 2 weeks. So patient of crate bite may require ventilation for more than 2 weeks also. That's a very important. Now importantly, while the cobra bite, reversal by atropine, neostigmine, yes, rapidly, but crate bite not reverse. Many times in India, neostigmine atropine work because Indian venous crate is both pre and post-synaptic. Next, into Russell viper is another biggest killer of the India farmers. Now, this Russell viper, very aggressive big snake. Daytime bite or early darkness bite. Paddy has farming now, the soybean plantation, sugar cane, grown-up grass, or this all cases are tea gardens where you get the maximum Russell viper. And Russell viper, the fangs are very big size. It moves by 180 degrees. And the fangs injected deep in intramuscular. That's why the venom is injected deep in intramuscular, which is highly vascular and rapidly absorbed. And 75% venom is absorbed. No sooner venom is injected, there is a huge edema and local DIC develop. So the fangs mark was, we get continuous oozing of blood. If you get oozing of blood continuous, local edema is a Russell viper virus. Only fangs mark with the clotel blood, with the local swelling, ecchymosis, the cobra bite. Now, if there is a minimum edema, coat, and that is, we get a says card. Now, we can get a blades, continuous bleeding, blades, necrosis, which can occur, compartment syndrome, which can develop by the Russell viper bite. Now, see, multiple bleeding, which can occur by the Russell viper bite. Now, two sides, even bleeding from ear, bleeding from the fangs, see, continuous bleeding from the fang side, is a diagnostic. Local DIC has been developed. Now, regional lymphadenitis, very important. If the bite is less, and if you get a regional lymphadenitis, confirm the patient is beaten in venom. This is very important. You should give the anti-venom. So, regional, never forget to examine regional lymphadenitis. Even cerebral infarct, this watershed infarct, which occurs because of thrombosis, which forms prothrombin, thrombin formation, we get thrombosis, a cerebral infarct, vasculitis, which can develop by Russell viper. Next important, this is very important. If you give congenital edema in the Russell viper bite, this is called leaking syndrome. And this leaking, the blood is leaking the lungs, even you get the pleural effusion. Next important, edematous, edema, the decreased urine output, renal failure, and respiratory failure is a diagnosis of leaking edema, mortar with shock. The mortality is very high in leaking edema. Now, sometimes Russell viper can cause neuroparalysis, which is common in Kerala reported. Even this woman has neuroparalysis. Most important, patient, this woman and men can develop Sian syndrome, amenorrhea, which can history of snake bite is very important because of necrosis and circulation. That is, portal circulation and pituitary gland cause necrosis, death of necrosis of pituitary gland cause amenorrhea, Sian syndrome, which is common seen rarely. If the brilliant obstetrician is able to take the history, dig out the history in a sterile woman with amenorrhea. Next important, renal failure is a common death and very high mortality. More than 30% patient die for renal failure because simple negligence of renal failure. Even at the PSC doctor is unaware. Yes, we given bleeding start, they discharge the patient. They never monitor urine output. Patient come with anorexia and vomiting. Anorexia, they attribute to acidity because of drugs, which is wrong. So that's a very important. Renal failure, 14%, irrespective of this, is very important. Neuroparalysis can occur. Now, it's simple. This is hemoglobinuria and this is hematuria. This hematuria, RBC is liberated. Hemoglobinuria, lysis of the blood has occurred. So, just simple monitoring of the urine will help whether you improve or not. Now, next important patient can, because this got a tumor necrosis factor and patient gets myocardial depression, ventricular arrhythmia. Will you give anti venom? Arrhythmia, disappear at the DC shock or cardiac rod may be required. Next important is that yes, we have been studied. If you how to prevent a renal failure, the reservoir, because highest mortality is a renal failure, and disability because of a local contraction. And now the renal failure is because of what? Yes, pre-renal failure shock. Next important, post-renal failure, MLA, the blocking of the tubules, interstitial nephritis, and the antigen antivenom reaction. This can result in nephritis and renal failure. Now, very important, we did 20 vial stat versus the 10 vial. We come to know if you give 20 vial because of venom is 75% venom is injected deep intramuscular, rapid peak of the venom has been raised in the circulation and rapid exit in urine. Maximum venom go to the urine or kidney, and kidney will maximum will be damaged earlier. So to neutralize the venom in circulation, if you give 20 vial, 200 ml of venom, minimum venom will reach to the kidney and minimum recovery. So renal failure can be prevented by giving the 20 vial ESV stat. Now the this is small snake which cause renal failure. This is tentative, a small bite has occurred. This causes renal failure. But big snake rarely cause much. Big snake did not. So small snake venom is different. The venom may be more toxic. It is immature venom, not fully formed, fully mature venom may not respond to the routine antivenom because venom is antivenom prepared from mature big snake. So small snake has a immature, incomplete structural venom may not respond to the antivenom. So this is again patient response. Now Ichthyoscale, soft-scaled viper, which is again very important. You see, while the farmer is walking in the walking grass, he said, I got a thorn prick. He now seen the snake. He come with a cellular increased edema. The surgeon or physician say, it is something thorn prick. And patient was treated and not actually diabetes, patient lose the limb. Because you see, when the patient is thorping and rapid edema within a couple of hours, diagnosis snake bite. Because no injury will cause edema within 1 hour, start inflammation 1 hour. It is the only in venom which can cause the rapid edema in 1 to 2 hours. So development of rapid edema with the ST of thorn bite diagnosed Ichthys bite. Next one, we can get a profuse bleeding on ecchymosis with disabled by antivenom. So we can get all the site of initial, the patient has say the dog bite and they run to the dog and then got a vehicle bite, two bites. So now many times patient could expectoration of blood stain sputum and patient give the history of viper bite 10 days before. Never, you are never late to give antivenom after 2 weeks even in viper bite. Remember, if the patient comes 2 weeks, bleeding from the injury, bleeding from the already from injury, or bleeding from the gums, or the history of liver function derangement, you will have to give antivenom. Now, this is various clinical signs. Renal failure is very rare in the Ichthys bite. Now, sea snake is very important. Patient of sea snake, very important, just like sea sprint, difficulty of something put in the throat, and the neurotic edema, muscle, severe muscle pain, respiratory depression, hyperkalemia, cardiac arrest. And this patient need not available ESV. Now, this patient got high treatment of hyperkalemia, very important. What is the diabetes? Calcium gluconate. So then you can give a dialysis. Next important, nothing ever, even sympathomimetic drugs or inhaler, you can give to reduce. And if the refractory hyperkalemia, you can give glibenclamide. This you see newer how, because glibenclamide is sodium channel blocker, which will prevent hyperkalemia. So glibenclamide is a drug of choice. Next important, thumb nose viper, we've seen in Pondicherry and Cochin has no antivenom, but it's called all clinical manifestations like viper bite, renal failure, local edema, ecchymosis, and now the brain damage which occur all over the bleeding. It has no antivenom available. We have to mito symptomatically with pre-radical study, FFP. Now this is a pit viper. Pit viper with no antivenom. Pit viper cause local edema, severe local edema, real bleeding disorder. It may cause renal failure, but I observed there is no regional lymphadenopathies. And this still we give antivenom, because of looking the paraspecificity character of the antivenom. Because the venom structure of maximum are mostly similar, little bit distributed between this viper venom. So paraspecificity, take an action, at least we can give antivenom. There's still controversy whether antivenom to be given or not. So now the small child with the pit viper, see? Coming with the pit viper, big for young, and he's recovered with antivenom. Now never give intramuscular, never hurry to give TT in this patient of snake bite. You will get a big hematoma, infection, and various complications. So never give intramuscular injection. while preparing antivenom, be sure it is not turbid. You witness that when the start preparing antivenom, it should be crystal clear, clear water. Or otherwise, if it's turbid, patient will develop severe reaction. Nekar, you must have magnification lens to see the crate by atropine neostigmine ampoules, that is adrenaline ampoules. Next important, never waste time for doing a test dose. No need to give test dose of antivenom at all. If you are in doubt, give subcutaneous adrenaline prophylaxis, start ESV. Please never, never give test dose. It is unnecessary claim and doesn't give guarantee. The guarantee that patient can prevent the anaphylaxis. So never give. What you must? You must have adrenaline. If you give antivenom, you must have adrenaline. You must ask the antihistamine, S2 blocker. You must have steroid, IV pill, ammonophile, oxygen. Doctors should sit by the side of patient till full dose of antivenom. If the reaction occurs, what will you do? First, inject adrenaline intramuscular, stop the drip, give injection intramuscular, then start, again develop, repeat the adrenaline every 5 minutes, 2 to 3 doses. If doesn't restart, you can give IV adrenaline. 1 ml of adrenaline contains 1000 milligram of the microgram of adrenaline. You add 1 ml to 9 ml of normal saline, so 10 ml. So 1 ml contains 100 microgram, you inject IV slow. And if such reaction develops, what to do? You change the batch of the antivenom. That batch may be, see, batch may contain very allergic to that patient, that horse prepared form may be allergic, horse blood may be allergic to the patient. Change the batch of the venom, antivenom, you may get success. So antivenom, specific antidote, a contraindication. There is no contraindication of antivenom. Full dose should be administered at PSC, then transfer the patient. Never transfer the patient ambulance with the drip of ESV is on. It should be full dose at PSC or private hospital, then transfer. Sign venom, no test dose. Don't afraid of anaphylaxis. Rapid development of swelling, which is very important diagnosis. Now, as much you must say, AmbuVac, working battery with a laryngoscope. Many times, battery is not working because we are not used to use laryngoscope. So this is working battery is very important. Now, you must have ventilator. Now, everybody got ventilator. If no tracheal, you can have a laryngeal mask, which can be put easily over the larynx. Now, which is, you see, history of snake bite, local edema absent, floor bed, crate bite. Local edema present, neuroparalysis, cobra bite. If bleeding, DIC, Russell viper. Local edema, aqueous bite, and ERV. This is very clear cut now. Now, dilatation of the pupils. See, the many times the crate bite patient or cobra dilatation pupil doesn't indicate irreversible brain damage because the iris is rich in vascular. The iris is rich in smooth muscle. Iris is rich in acetylcholine receptor. So maximum venom because of acetylcholine is rich in the iris. And that's why ptosis, again, levator papillary muscle has a more acetylcholine receptor. That's why ptosis earlier. Your iris, because of blockage acetylcholine receptor, become dilated, non-reactive. And that is the reason it doesn't indicate the brain death at all. So dilated people doesn't indicate brain death. So ultimately, why they are pain? What we say to the prevention is the mother of cure. Simple cot or appropriate use of mosquito net will prevent crate bite, snake bite, mosquito bite, the encephalite, chikungunya, Ebola, and Wartner virus disease prevent. So ultimately, this is a typical mosquito net you can use. Now, this is open toilet is one of the culprit. Now, it is not lost, but open and still exists. Now, the duty, what you feel? When you save the earning member of family, it is duty done. Father, mother, husband, wife, social worker, or scientist. This team satisfaction, Dr. Gay. You will see the God in the patient the next day morning when the neuropathic patients sit and talk with you. You get the experience and competence for to teach the next victim. What is the conclusion? Early reporting, rapid diagnosing, proper dose of ESV, adjunct treatment may help prevent subsequent death. Now remember, tell me, I will forget. I am telling you the snake bites, you will forget while passing through the night or her. But show and maybe, Maya, you may remember something, slide. But involve me, I will understand. If you treat the case, then you understand. Real my lecture, my dream. This is the Mashaguran who has helped me, encouraged me from Israel. He has worked in snake bite last 35 years. And I was the first reporter of vasodilator. He has said, you did a supermo job in the world. Is a report from Israel. Last year, he died. So this is important. No Indian doctor has sent me the congratulations. Sri Bhaskar is doing a good job doing research, that's all. And my teacher, who is my boy, said it's a good mind. And he asked, why I could do a research? He's a pathologist. My teacher was a pathologist. And in the first lecture, he said, pathology is the mother of medical science. My dear friend, I mug up the boy's pathology. That's why I could do a research in the life. Remember, basic science is very important. A snake bite, too. Yes, prevention can be done. Now the important thing is this local toilet, open toilets to prevent it. Even the Raigad, Chhatrapati Shivaji, 300 years before, for their Queen Mahal, there is a local toilet. Now the government is building a toilet, they are using as a bathroom. They are using a storeroom. This is the worst part of India. Now tourniquet, everybody know. Now this patient under treatment today in our hospital. See, look at in the morning. What happens in 12 nights? She don't know, something is bitten. Patient bought with LM30 with a ptosis, unable to move, and she's recovering 12 hours now. Yes, we know treatment is a great way. So my dear friend, why to say the venom and toxin? Coagulation cascade studied by the, McFarney added the hemophilic blood, the viper venom to hemophilic blood and clotted. And coagulant cascade was studied to get a Nobel Award, McFarney. Myasthenia gravis antibody study detected by the CRATE antibody. Clot buster thrombolysis from cobra venom. ACE inhibitors from viper venom. Lisinopril, this ACE inhibitor, seismography, saprotoxin, couplet, rabies bunkrotoxin can be used to treat anti-venom. Now this is, now I think is, now my dear friend, last slide. Everything is over. We got anti-venom against snake, anti-venom spark. But my dear friend, we don't have anti-venom against terrorists, against war. We want today anti-venom against war. That is Ishwar Allah, Teranam, Sapho, Sanmati, Devagwan. No religion is higher than religion of humanity. And no service higher than service to motherland. At least we cannot go to fight the war, but at least the soldier or the motherland or the person is coming to your OPD, you serve him, is equal to the serving to the nation. So my dear friend, I'm son of a farmer, did a research, successful research, failure many times, now ready to return. And this is backbone of my research is my wife. This is very important. Because I got no tension at home, at all, nothing, no tension at all, no screwing, nothing doing. You go whatever you want to, what you invest, what you want, do it and do it just now. There's no problem. So this is very important. The scientific work, scientific research need free mind from the house. That is very important. That is culture developed. You see, this is Michael Gorbachev cried when he was a funeral of his wife. So this is very important. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for that truly inspiring and enlightening talk. I think the most important message that you gave is the importance of monitoring the child, sitting beside the patient, and also looking for simple clinical signs with which you can diagnose many important points in snake bite and scorpion sting. Thank you very much, sir.
I would like to invite Ananda Keshwan, sir, our South Zone Vice President, to say a few words. Come in, sir.
So, I'm audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible, sir. Sir, you're audible, sir.
So, good evening, respected chairperson and chief guest Bhaskar, sir, and also Sumaran, sir, other dignitaries. It is a really inspiring story by Dr. Bhaskar. Even though I heard his talk three times, again and again, I am forced to hear it again. It is inspiring from the base of the heart. We are also seeing so many cases of snake bite and scorpion sting, but I think we don't know how such a good collection. When we are studying Calicut Medical College, CBC sir was one of the pioneer in the treatment of a snake bite. And also his sentence in the Hridayathinte Ullil Ninnu Varunna Bhasha, വികാര സാറിന് കേട്ടാൽ മനസ്സിലാവില്ല, വികാര നിർഭരമായ ഹൃദയത്തിന്റെ ഉള്ളിൽ നിന്ന് വരുന്ന ആ ടോക്ക്, ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വെരി റിയലി ഇൻസ്പിരിങ്. സിറ്റിംഗ് വിത്ത് ദി പേഷ്യന്റ്, വൈപ്പർ കില്ലർ ഓഫ് ദി ഫാമേഴ്സ്, മോണിറ്റർ ഫ്രം സൈഡ് ഓഫ് ദി പേഷ്യന്റ്, ആൻഡ് സോ മെനി തിങ്സ് വി ഹാവ് ടു ലേൺ ഫ്രം ഹിം, ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഹൈപ്പോതെമിയ ഫോർ ട്രോസിസ് ടെസ്റ്റ്. So many things are there. So I want to ask Jayashran 2-3 questions. Bhaskar sir, can you hear me?
Yes.
So, so I had like experience with a bad snake bite. That is, a snake was not identified. Child got severe reaction following ASV. So I have to give ASV under cover of adrenaline.
Yes.
After 24-48 hours, we explained the seriousness of the ASV, adrenaline, everything. Unluckily, after 48 hours, the child developed bilateral cortical blindness. Whether it is due to ASV, it is due to snake bite, it is due to adrenaline, because child got, and it is completely reversed. It was cortical blindness. At that time, CT scan MRI was not there, but child got the bilateral cortical blindness and child completely recovered. So what may be the mechanism?
Now the cortical blindness is because of vasoconstriction or vasculitis which might be developed. It's very important in this patient because we have just said now the reverse vasculitis, vasospasm or vasculitis which can be reversed by the drugs. That's the reason. And next important thing.
Yes,
next important thing is you would have changed the batch of the ASV. I just talked with the patient, doesn't respond to the recoil repeated. You change the batch of ASV. Because that's a horse, my horse plasma may be, but horse content may be allergic to that patient. You change the batch.
Okay, and you mentioned about the slow release of toxin cobra bite. So how long give ASV in if needed in a cobra bite? How long, up to what time you are giving ASV in case of cobra bite?
No, the problem is, no, son, patient will come with ASV, we give maximum neurotoxin 20 vials. First, you add a 10 vials and see the neuropathy. Yes, sir. If the neuropathy improve half hour, you add next 10 vials. Maximum is 20 vials. And you follow. Relapse can occur because I said the depot which occur at the bedside and vasculitis is lost, that is because of my necrosis and venom remains there. That venom is very slowly absorbed because of poor vasculitis which can the relapse. That's why we have to follow. We have to add the next again 10 vials of ASV. So maximum neuropalsy 25.
And we had a lot of cases of snake bites when we are studying near Calicut is near the seashore only. We manage all cases without any ASV.
Yes.
By just simply by as you mentioned, without ASV supportive measures only we manage. What's your opinion, sir?
Yes. No, you see, my problem is that when the patient has when the venom have reached to the receptor site. No anti-venom will release that, will remove this receptor action. Now, what we are doing, remember three things. Recovery of the patient depends on oxygenation, nutrition, and electrolyte balance. Oxygenation can be maintained by ventilator, BiPAP, or Artemis. Nutrition rise to electrolyte balance. If you maintain three things, patient will stay recovered. So these are the three things we have to maintain rather than ASV. Yes, we will call rapid recovery. This will delay the recovery. Patient will recover, but you need close mind. Just like early stage, will acetylenoxin, prazosin, take 3 days now, 48 hours. When would anti-venom recovery start? Similar thing happen here. Patient with 100% recover, but depend close monitoring and maintenance of oxygen, nutrition, electrolyte balance.
So thank you, sir. Thank you for the wonderful session. Over to Jayashna.
One question. So what's the experience with the neostigmine, sir?
Neostigmine, we give generally 25 microgram per kg body weight as a first dose. Similar, that is, and lateral on dose is reduced for first, if it is not available, 2.5 milligram stat in adult with atropine. Then 5 milligram every half hourly till the patient recover. If the patient dose is improved and if the patient has a chance, then you start intramuscular 1 hourly, then 2 hourly, 3 hourly, and 6 hourly.
Okay.
It depends on individual actually. That is a fixed dose is not there for neostigmine.
Okay.
So there has been a question from the chat box, sir. What can mimic a scorpion sting if there is no clinical clear history? Is there anything which can present similarity to scorpion sting and not a scorpion sting?
Yes. No. What was that?
Sir, is there anything which can present like a scorpion sting, the clinical features? But it is not actually a clinic, it is not actually a scorpion sting. What can mimic a scorpion sting? If there is no
priapism can occur in rabies.
Okay.
Yes, that is important. Even the priapism, you can see in a rabies. Okay. With the vomiting, sweating, all sign you can see in the rabies.
Okay. Sir, I would like to invite Sukumaran, sir, for his comments, sir.
Hello?
Hello. Yes, sir, you're audible, sir.
Audible. Yes,
sir. Audible, sir.
Oh, beloved Jijo and my dear friends, it was an excellent talk. And it is really fantastic. My hearty congratulations for sir for the excellent presentation also. We got a lot of newer ideas and newer points in the management and in the clinical diagnosis of human snake bite. There were a lot of newer points were there. And actually, it was a fantastic talk. And my question to sir is that, what is the, you said the maximum dose is only 20 vials. Suppose the child is still having signs of envenomation. Can you increase the dose of antivenom?
Yes, no problem is now Cobra and Crate 20 vial maximum. This Rimpa Kamba come with a Russell Viper bite. Now the Russell Viper bite, you start 20 vial after 6 hours. Of 20 vial, do the 20 minute clotting test.
Yeah.
20 minute whole blood clotting test.
Yes.
If the blood is not, suppose patient come Russell Viper, 20 vial is given, and still acute bleeding occur after half hour. Epistaxis, bleeding from MHR, okay. You can add next 10 vials again to HV. Because maximum requirement of Russell Viper in my area is 40 vials. Total. 6 hours, you can repeat because within 6 hours, you are not supposed to repeat because 6 hour duration has required liver to replace the coagulation factor. After 6 hours, 20 minute clotting test, if it doesn't clot, you add 5 vials. After 6 hours, to not clotting, add 5 vials. After 6 hours, like this, you can go on adding till the patient starts clotting. But remember, if the patient got on the third and fourth day, patient is come young, in coagulation blend, think of DIC. Here, antivenom will not work. Here, we have to do FFP or plasma replacement therapy. Antivenom will not work. So that a DIC is totally different, which can be diagnosed by this, looking at RBC, criminated RBC, or various rigid diamond relevation. Next important, renal failure. When the, many doctors think renal failure 20 vials over, then never you and more and more ESV because this will not going to help unless you improve the dialysis, improve the renal function at all. Next important, tocin will remain for 1 month. Don't kill the ESV part till the tocin improve. So it is a problem of the Russell Viper. An important thing, that's how we are telling, there should be regional venom and anti-venom bank. You see, Russell Viper in my area 40, Russell other area may require 60 to 80 vials. Because the venom prepared from that typical area, typical venom is different than the different part of it. Venom depends on the diet, whatever the source of the snake it got eating, that is responsible for the venom. Environment also, the character of venom is changing according to region to region. That's why we said we should prepare a venom bank of the region and venom anti-bank, which will reduce the requirement of anti-venom.
Thank you, sir, for the excellent talk. My hearty congratulations to IAP Pathanamthitta for organizing this monsoon webinar. Thank you, Jijo. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Purushottaman, sir, can I have a few comments, sir?
Thank you. It was a wonderful experience from you. And we had a few cases of death before 2003 case we died. And once we read about your article and Mahadevan, sir, from Pondicherry. And since we started using prazosin, no deaths till today. My two doubts, sir. One thing, how freely is this antivenom available? It's not available in Kerala, I think. The next thing is, what's your experience with cytosorb? In few institutions, Kerala, we're using this cytosorb. It's very expensive. We don't have in government setup. It's not, we didn't use it. Did you use it, cytosorb?
Antivenom?
No, sir. In case of viper bite and all, cytokine adsorbing thing.
No, we didn't use.
Okay, sir. About antivenom, about this, it's available in liberally in Maharashtra.
Yes, sir. Antivenom is available in napkin, and its cost is less now 200 or 300 rupees per vial.
Scorpion.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
But you enjoy the antivenom. You start antivenom processing in 8 hours, patient will go at home.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, that's for the last 20 years, yes, sir. Okay. Since we started using that. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Sir, we'll move on to the final session, sir. So first of all, thank you. Thank you. And we believe, like what you said, sir, this is an opportunity for us to appreciate you and learn from your experience, sir. You have been practicing ever before we were born itself. Most of us were born here to be practicing and learning about scorpion and snake bite. It is an honor for all of us to have listened to you, to learn from your experience. Pictures speak volumes rather than just what we read from textbooks. And for everyone who has attended this has learned more points and will definitely put all the things which we have learned in managing patients. It has been an honor for accepting this and joining us today, sir. We will hope to learn from you more. We have been reading about that newer research that you have been doing, sir, including lead toxicity and multiple things which you have been going into, sir. We are hoping to get positive results on that also, sir. Hoping to see more articles from you in the future, sir. This has been a great pleasure for all of us, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you for calling me again, please.
And with which, sir, we are ending the... I will also like to invite Balachandra, sir, for a few comments, sir. Balachandra, sir, he is the secretary of our state, sir.
What, sir?
Thank you, Joe.
Yes, sir.
First of all, let me congratulate IIT Pathanamthitta for organizing this very important topic, which we don't hear in our routine CMEs. And also to bringing our Bhavaskar, sir, who is a pioneer in treating scorpion and snake venoms. I had my PG at Sassoon Hospital, BJ Medical College, Pune, where I did 25 years back. I could see a lot of scorpion stings and could treat with the lighted cocktail and all. But after that, coming back to Kerala, I haven't seen a case of scorpion bite, even though we could hear with his alleged history of scorpion bite, but without any systemic effects. So, one point I could get from Bhavaskar sir is that the whole responsibility is on the medical officer. Recently we had a bad case at Wayanad. So from that experience and from Bhavaskar sir's presentation, I think we should give ASV without any fear, and whatever anaphylaxis, whatever happens, we should manage. That's what I could infer from sir's talk. And I would like to ask sir one question. Have you got any data for anaphylaxis to anti-snake venom? Experience in your experience with ASV?
Important thing is, you see, we get a good minimum reaction to Hapkin. But Bharat and other institutes serum, we got a more anaphylactic reactions. Now this anaphylactic reaction is common in some we report 20% cases. And maximum we report in 4% case of anaphylaxis. Important thing is how you manage the patient. That is a very important. Earliest stage treatment of anaphylaxis. And reporting. If just articular, you say anaphylaxis, that reporting goes to more than 40%. If a real anaphylaxis, hypotension, the articaria, vomiting, respiratory problem, then it comes near about to less than 10%.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Pathanamthitta. Thank you, Binu and Gino. Thank you,
sir. So the take-home message for all of us is suspect with varying clinical features and give ASV, suspect a scorpion if you are in an area where scorpions are common, and treat early, treat right. And we are hoping all this message will be passed to all of us. We will be circulating the YouTube video to all of us, all the other groups also. Thank you for your time, sir, with which we are ending the session for today, sir. Thank you so much for us.
You can send me the PDF file if it's available of this.
Yes, sir. I'll send it to you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you
okay.
so much, sir. Thank you. Okay. Jay Krishnan, sir, a big thank you, sir, for joining us, sir. It is, sir, somebody whom we ask doubts when we have a snake bite poisoning, how to go ahead with it. Sir is the right person to join us because he's the one who's been managing quite a few number of cases in Calicut Medical College where the poisoning is much more higher. Thank you for joining us, sir, today.
Thank you, Jejo. Thank you, Binu Kutan, and all the people. IAP team, Pathanamthitta.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
We are ending the meeting for today, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Great time.